occupée par la France pour mercenariat. Historiquement, la France considère la République centrafricaine comme son livret de caisse d'épargne. C'est-à-dire qu'elle pense et elle croit que tout ce qui est dans le sous-sol est à elle. Il n'y a personne d'autre. C'est un livret de caisse d'épargne que l'on met en épargne, on n'y touche pas.
Mm. Et ça tilhører Frankrig, et ça tilhører ikke andre. Et c'est stadigvæk holdningen, siger han.
Dans le sous-sol, on a du cuivre, du fer, du manganèse, du cobalt, de l'uranium, du mercure rouge. Il y a tout ça, on sait où, mais à chaque fois qu'on demande une subvention, une aide ou quelque chose pour faire des phases d'exploitation, on a des problèmes.
Vous êtes empêché.
Mais comment?
Quand vous voulez empêcher quelqu'un de courir,
ouais.
On met un caillou dans la chaussure.
Ouais, oui.
Si on veut empêcher un État de se développer,
oui.
Les ressources qu'il va utiliser pour courir après des rebelles, mm-hmm. Il ne pourra pas les utiliser pour se développer.
This is Ernesto, my tennis coach in Bangui. We are playing a double against the Indian consul Paul and a man from the French energy consortium Areva. The guy from Areva was in town because the French, now backed with Chinese money, was finally getting ready to explore the legendary uranium mine at Bakuma, close to Bangui. It's a story which goes back to Emperor Bokassa, who would threaten to sell the uranium to the Chinese whenever he wanted to put a squeeze on the French. But now, the French and the Chinese had joined hands at Bakuma. Paul, the Indian consul, was almost an exact copy of the man I was making myself into. He was also mixing business and diplomacy in bewildering ways.
Thank you for the match, Paul. It's fantastic to win my first tennis match the Central African Republic.
And to my amazement, he had also had plans to open up a match factory in the Central African Republic.
Let's start with the matches, because I'm curious why you did not do it.
I told you it was a little bit difficult. The country is not secure, so everybody got the gun, so anything is can happen anytime.
Yes.
It's really complicated, this country, man. You have to be careful. They will eat your money and they kick you on your ass. So be careful with these people. The people, they lost millions of dollars here in the night. Millions of dollars. I was here, I saw the people. They will come here 4 o'clock in the house and put you the gun and tell you whole money which you have here to give us. This is, we got order. And the same time everywhere on your office.
Who did that happen to?
They. It's happened with all the diamond people. They lost their own money. $1.5 million, one company they lost in the night. Don't tell anybody about your plans. You just came to open your...
My consulate?
Yeah, consulate, fine.
Yes. I shouldn't talk about my business plans.
No. It's not a time.
I was thinking about telling
you. You can talk with the counselors.
Yes.
But be careful with the counselor of, what you say, Netherlands.
Netherlands?
Yeah.
Yes.
You have to be careful with Belgium, all the European.
Yes.
Because they are reporting to the ambassador of France.
Yes. And I want to steer clear of France.
Other African consulate, there is no problem. But these people, you have to be careful.
The Central African Republic is murky waters for white men, and the mere sight of a Caucasian, pigment-challenged male in Bangui can ignite wild speculations about mercenaries and plans to overthrow the president. For example, a group of Slovakian safari tourists were arrested and charged with plans to commit a state coup some months ago. Therefore, being a traveler in dire straits, I had to take great care that my travel papers were in absolute order.
This is Mr. Kotchen calling.
Yes, how are you doing?
I'm okay, William, but I just found out I have bought the diplomatic handbook for Liberia, and in the book it says that the Liberian diplomatic passports are so-called ECOWAS passports. They are biometric. and they are black.
Yeah.
But the one I have is red and it's not biometric.
I thought you had a new one, a new passport, because I did not unwrap it.
I'm just worried if someone here in Bangui, they see my passport and they call Monrovia and ask, who is this guy? What will they tell them?
They will not phone, because who will they phone?
Excuse me?
Who the hell wants to phone?
To explain why I chose Willem Thyssen as my diplomatic title broker, it's because Colin Evans, my preferred choice, could not deliver.
Put them in my office, tray of tea, something like that.
I would like a cup of tea, actually, that would be nice.
When I went to see him in Portugal for a second meeting, together with my secretary Maria, he explained to me he had difficulties finding a country that wanted to establish diplomatic connections with the Central African Republic.
The major problem with CAR at the moment,
yes,
is that those nations that wish to be associated with them are already represented there in some form.
Yeah.
And those that aren't don't wish to be.
This was a personal matter to Colin Evans because he actually works for the Central African Republic as a diplomat himself. Here he is seen in front of a painting of President Buzise, posing with a suspicious-looking Asian guy.
It is the forgotten country of Africa. Mm. I mean, obviously, I know. I do work for them, but I also know what, if I could say this in front of you, Maria, complete pain in the arse.
Yeah.
The CAR can be.
Yes.
I don't go there.
No.
I represent them externally in a number of levels, but I don't personally go there. I prefer not.
But I think, you know, they spend most of their time here thinking constantly about black magic. Mm-hmm. They all go to the Madibu, the local wizard, to buy magic powder and to make him do voodoo against other people and so on. And the magic they respect most is the pygmies.
Mm-hmm.
Because supposedly they have the best wizards. So I think, you know, to give the matches a unique selling point, that they are made by pygmies.
Pygmies, yeah.
Mm. I think it will have an attraction to the Africans. Not for you and me, we will not care about it. But, but for the Africans it will be really... Really, Paul, it's not to be racistic, but, you know, I have a problem with Asian people. They are always very sneaky, they're very greedy. Difficult to trust.
Difficult.
And they have bad manners.
They want to take everything for themselves.
Yes.
They are very selfish.
So, Monsieur Gilbert, I make my proposal to him.
Yes.
And we discuss it, and if he likes it, we take it to the lawyer tomorrow.
Okay.
So, Paul, please translate this. I understand that he likes the small bulldozer, but what he needs now is a fast cash investment.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
So I ask him now, what does he like, the 10 million francs or the bulldozer?
We have the bulldozer, the 10 million.
What? The 10 million.
Perfect, Monsieur Gilbert.
Right. Thank you.
Okay, thank you.
Yes.
Thank you, Paul.
We are in train de faire un investissement préliminaire avec un monsieur qui s'appelle Gilbert Dalkia. Vous le connaissez?
Oui.
Et à votre avis, c'est une bonne idée?
Ça dépend si c'est vous qui le maîtrisez ou s'il fait ce qu'il veut.
Comment est-ce qu'on fait pour bien le maîtriser alors? Pour éviter que l'autre chose se passe?
Ici, il faut connaître les relations des gens l'un avec l'autre. Si il pense que vous avez de bonnes relations avec des gens plus puissants que lui, il se comportera correctement. S'il pense l'inverse, vous repartirez
ça,
en ayant
ça,
tout perdu.
Mais ça est le meilleur mystère.
Hi, Mr. Gorton from Central African Republic. How are you doing?
I'm very fine, thank you, William.
the diplomatic passport I have now, can I use that here in Central Africa? Is it possible for me to use it here?
Yeah, you can use it.
But, you know, I don't have any, you know, accreditation papers with me.
Yeah, I know.
Embers of the Congo when it's gleaming in the night. Ever see the jungle with the animals in fright? Put me in the Congo and the jungle and I'm right.
Ah, the envelope shop. So Paul, here is 100,000. It make him happy. So when here is the envelope of happiness.
Yes.
And then we go to the meeting with the secretary of the president. But we don't. I don't give the envelope to him.
Straight to him. The kind artist, if you corrupt him or things like that.
I will make him feel dirty.
Yes.
But the envelope is for him. Yes.
Yes.
To make him feel happy.
Yes.
Let's make some business.
Yes.
Powerful feeling now. Now, Paul, I really feel like the black albino. White on outside, but really, really black inside. Yes.
Lucky for me, my cover as a business diplomat with lofty plans to open up a match factory brought me in contact with the most powerful people in Bangui.
Peut-être vous, Monsieur Corson.
Ah, oui.
Monsieur.
Monsieur.
Oui, je prends une photo.
The last time we had a meeting, it was also in darkness. Then suddenly the light came, and then he said to me, you bring out the light.
I explained to Minister Gaston that I had imported matchmaking know-how from India and was busy setting up a production of matches in Bangui.
But also because I believe in sustainable development and supporting tribal people, I would like, within this workshop, to employ a pygmy.
To form l'homme, pour que l'homme devienne productif, y compris le pygmy.
Han siger, at du har fat i en sag, en hjertesag for ham, der handler om altså den menneskelige udvikling også.
Oui, oui.
Og at du uddanner. Og det er meget vigtigt, og især når det drejer sig om pygmæerne, at man forsøger at hæve menneskets niveau, eller højne menneskets niveau, simpelthen.
Oui. I would be very happy if the minister could support and help with this endeavor.
Jeg er en train de m'installer dans un village où les populations, première population autochtone, sont des pygmæer. Ils sont encore là, non loin de là où j'habite.
Oui.
Donc on peut avoir accès à eux sans problème. Je pense que vous êtes intéressé. Donc je peux m'investir pour aller voir le chef du village.
Meanwhile, a local artist was ready to present the artwork needed for the matchboxes.
Wow, this is nice. So this says l'ambassadeur, he lights up Africa. It says in tribal language, he lights up Africa. Made by the pygmies.
You know, pygmies you are telling.
Yes.
How do they look?
They are small and very black.
So we have to put here black.
And this is for the workshop, because I want to explain to the pygmies who the enemy is. And this is because I want to tell them they have to stop depending on the French and the Chinese and empower themselves. La baguette.
Baguette.
Yes. C'est un homme français. Mm. C'est un homme chinois.
Il sait que la chinoise, comme ça.
Han siger, at håret skal være mere fransk, skal stå mere op, og så skal kineserne se mere kinesisk ud, så øjnene skal være mindre. Wow, men det er flot på.
The only way to become a certified diamond dealer in the Central African Republic runs through the Department of Mines in Bangui. To obtain the government's approval of my partnership with Monsieur Gilbert, I was told to sign a standard contract issued by the Department of Mines.
Et c'est grâce à ce contrat que
Si par exemple, M. Dantia trouve la coopérative trouve des diamants et qu'il veut exporter, ça va sortir légalement. Donc ça c'est l'objectif de ce contrat.
So I can take stones with me to Europe.
Yes, to Europe.
This paper will be like the Swiss army knife of contracts.
Donc ce papier ça sera comme l'arme suisse quoi.
Merci.
Oui.
But this Swiss army knife of contracts stipulated that I would oblige myself to pay all Monsieur Gilbert's expenses forever. In order to avoid this, I went to a law office in Bangui, recommended to me by Minister Gaston. The head of the office, who is a member of parliament by the way, would help us to make a modified version of the contract. In short, business was good.
So, Paula, how long is the drive to the Pygmies?
To reach there is only 20 minutes.
Is the minister out there waiting for us?
Yes, he's waiting for us.
We have soap and cigarettes for the Pygmies?
Yes, yes, yes. We have cigarettes, we have soap, we have small, small things.
So they
and
will...
the missus are there. As we're still there, he wants to buy some wines and some drink to make the small celebration with them, to see them dancing and...
A Pygmy party?
Party.
Wow! Did the minister ever meet Bokassa?
Bokassa, oui, je connais, il m'a emprisonné.
Ah oui?
Ah oui?
Oui?
Elle s'est en fait.
Oh
là là! The Pygmies, they live close to here?
Ils ont plus de coin ici.
Sur là-bas?
Is it the drums of the Pygmies I can hear?
Oui. Ils se sont mis à danser, ils ont fait sortir l'esprit sous forme de tourbillon. Dans le village. Ils ont fait un tourbillon.
De har simpelthen lavet en skypumpe ved kraft af deres, de har taget deres tøj af og spyndet det rundt i luften. Og så...
Wow, magnifik.
So we want to see the pygmies in their natural, special power.
So when we go and meet them, they will be very happy, very excited.
Excited. They're always excited.
Very excited indeed. Since the early morning hours, Minister Gaston had been pouring liters of red wine and African moonshine into his pygmies, and now the whole tribe, including the children, were in an alcohol-induced state of trance.
You see, Paul, this is what the NGO people don't understand. You can really have fun in Africa.
Yes.
In the middle of this, Minister Gaston made me a proposal I could not resist. The opportunity to meet face to face with the Minister of Defense, the son of the President, Francis Bozize.
You see, this is the way.
Yes.
If we can meet the son of the President, one day, the son is on the way to succeed his father.
He will become the President. Yes.
We need better to prepare some money.
For the minister?
For the minister.
Like an envelope of happiness?
An envelope, yes.
Yes. Yes, no problem.
Then the chief of the tribe appeared and said they had selected a pygmy assistant for me.
He's in the bush.
He's in the bush?
Yes.
Ah, what is he doing in the bush?
Okay, they are hunting.
Ah. With a call. Okay, but please tell him hello for me and that I look forward to working with him. Merci beaucoup pour les danses, les pygmies. Could you say that? Thank you for the dance, wonderful pygmies. I would like to end my speech with... a quote from the famous American general, General Patton. General Patton said, if you tell people where to go without explaining them how to do it, you will be amazed of the results. Merci beaucoup. Yes, they like the speech?
They like the speech.
Ah, good.
When they clap, they make the whistle.
Yes, it means they're happy.
They are very happy.
It was a good speech?
Good speech.
Thank you, Paul.
Very strong. And,
yes.
To touch art.
Yes, it's important to reach in and touch people's art. Yes. Hello, William, this is Mats calling.
Hi, Mats, how are you doing?
William, I think we need to do the following, because, you know, I am really in a you know, messy situation here because tomorrow I am meeting with the son of the president. He is the minister of defense. He thinks I'm a Liberian diplomat. I am spending millions of francs on envelopes of happiness for him because he is important for the facilitation of the matches factory. And, you know, and
completely out.
What do you say, William?
Matt. Hello. Hello.
Hello, can you hear me?
Please repeat, I don't hear anything.
Oh, but William, can you hear me? William? William, can you hear me now?
William Sisson could not hear me, and that was a shame because he had not delivered all the goods I had paid him for. Some months ago, he came back to Copenhagen to collect the first installment, $50,000.
So, greetings from Dr. Eastman.
When you take out that much money, the bank would provide you with this money.